Marjorie Taylor Greene has racked up dozens of fines over the last few months alone for refusing to wear a mask in the Capitol building. The first offense was only $500. Every offense after that was $2,500. And she has now been fined at least $48,000. Now, here's the thing. That money, she doesn't have to pay it. You know, it's not like you're issued a ticket and you have to go and you write a check or whatever. You swipe your debit card. No, no, no. This money, because it's a fine she has to pay to the House, comes directly out of her paycheck. So she has no choice but to pay it because, again, comes right out of your check right there. So her salary as a member of Congress is $174,000 a year. She's already lost $48,000 for refusing to wear a mask, meaning she has lost 27% of her yearly pay, a little over a quarter of her yearly pay, just because she can't remember to wear a mask or because she wants to make a statement by not wearing a mask. A quarter of her salary. And let's also not forget that she admitted last week that she is not vaccinated. So every time she walks around there without a mask on, she could be spreading COVID-19 in the halls of Congress. That's what makes this story even more disgusting after learning, of course, that she's not vaccinated. But don't shed a tear for Marjorie losing a quarter of her salary. Oh, no, no, no. Marjorie's going to be just fine. And that brings me to the real issue. The thing with Marjorie Taylor Greene that people haven't really focused on. How much money she has. Now, there's no official number for her net worth that I could find. But I did find several websites that say that her unofficial net worth, that has not been verified, by the way, could be between $30 and $50 million. Her family owned a very successful contracting company in the state of Georgia. Many years ago, Marjorie, who actually, from what I read, has a master's degree in business administration, bought the company from her family, so now she owns it. And then after that thing kind of was self-sustaining, she went on, started a CrossFit gym. So she makes money off that. Marjorie Taylor Greene is making a heck of a lot of money. Not from Congress. So getting fined all this money does nothing to her. We also found out recently that she invested $50,000 into Donald Trump's social media company. You know, most members of Congress, not most members of Congress, I can't even say that, because most of them do. But you take any member of the squad, I doubt any of them have $50,000 lying around to just invest in a social media company. But anyway, she has money. So punishing her financially does nothing. She is unvaccinated. She is at risk of spreading this disease to other people. So there needs to be some kind of harsher punishment for her. Hell, there needs to be harsher punishment for everybody. Because after a while, they just become numb to the fines. And if you're like Marjorie Taylor Greene and most other members of Congress, you're making plenty of money on the side to where it doesn't matter how much of your salary they take away, because your real money is coming from all your other investments, all your other businesses, all the companies you own. Because Congress is a millionaire's club for the most part, and it's a big club, and we ain't in it. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.